help dreams come true.
The Easter Seal Telethon, tonight, starting at 11:30, only on Channel 4.
This year, we're counting on your support.
Jefferson, Monroe, Madison.
No, it's Madison, then Monroe.
I should just give up.
No, you've come too far.
Imagine the joy in helping someone make a dream come true.
I hereby declare.
Take the time to care.
Michigan Democratic campaign coffers are swelling with new donations from a big annual fundraiser. Tonight, bus travelers across the country remain stranded as the Greyhound strike continues. Tonight, the Red Wings play with determination, slapping in goal after goal to solidify their playoff position.
News for Nightbeat with Dan Mountney, Jennifer Moore, Paul Long, and Fred McLeod.
Good evening. It is closer than you think. A trip to the ballot box to make a political choice. Primaries are coming up in Michigan late this summer, and that means politics moves to the forefront. Tonight, more than 2,000 of the party faithful turned out in downtown Detroit for the annual Jeff Jack Dinner, paying for the chance to hear those who carry the Democratic Party banner, including the state's governor. News 4's Ned McGrath was on hand.
This was a night for Democrats to be Democrats and nothing else. Nobody worries about equal time for opposing viewpoints at an event like this. Nobody. And for some politicians, this was a chance at stand-up comedy, or something close to it. Vice President Dan Quayle, the butt of these jokes, delivered by Attorney General Frank Kelly.
What do you want to apologize for? When the president wanted you to go to Central America, you just went off and went to Iowa and Illinois and you forgot to come to Michigan.
The annual Jefferson Jackson fundraising dinner, $125 a plate for salad, shish kebab, and speeches, and believe it or not, short speeches, from Carl Levin, who wants another 6 years in the Senate.
My friends, they tell me that I'm a target. After two terms in the United States Senate, if I weren't a target, I'd wonder what the hell I've stood for 11 years.
And from Jim Blanchard, ready for a third go at the governor's office.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this may be an election year. It's going to be a very tough election year. It's going to be tough for Carl and tough for me and tough for all of us out here in an uncertain world.
How tough? Well, no one in this crowd wants to get too specific about that.
I think there's a lot of tough issues out there. I couldn't really identify one from the other. They're all tough issues.
Like abortion, an issue that will likely generate more heat than light.
I don't think that issue has any party affiliation. I believe that this is an individual issue, and it should be decided on that basis.
Meanwhile, back at the party, a headcount tallies 2,200 in attendance, and the band played on.
Which brings us back to the purpose of this little get-together tonight, to raise money, $200,000 this evening. But party officials estimate they need $1 million in their war chest to run against the Republicans in 1990. On the Nightbeat in downtown Detroit, Ned McGrath, News 4.
On the Republican side, GOP gubernatorial candidate John Engler has gotten a check for almost $500,000 in public matching funds for his campaign. Engler says he'll use those funds to get his message out to voters. So far, he's been pushing his property tax reduction proposal, a plan criticized by the Democrats. Detroit authorities are investigating a train accident that has left one woman dead tonight. Officials say the 49-year-old woman was walking on the railroad tracks when the train hit her. That accident happened just after 8 o'clock tonight west of the I-75 north of Davison. A striking Greyhound bus driver crushed to death today by a company bus in Northern California. He was one of dozens of pickets demonstrating in Reading in the second day of the Greyhound strike. The company says it was an accident, not an act of violence. While picket lines here in Detroit are calm, tensions have been rising elsewhere in the driver's strike. No negotiations have been scheduled. The company now says it's got 25% of its lines running, but passengers are wary and looking for other ways to get where they're going.
Originally, I was going by Greyhound to Chicago, and I'm flying out of Chicago tomorrow morning.
So you got to get there.
Right. To catch my flight.
Now, besides the inconvenience, are you paying more doing it this way?
No. All I had to do was go down to Greyhound. I got the ticket in advance, and I went to Greyhound, and they validated the ticket, and I thought I had to pay some extra, but no, they accepted the ticket. They just exchanged the Greyhound for Amtrak's.
Amtrak is honoring the value of Greyhound tickets, helping out passengers if the train will take them to the city they hope to reach by bus. A lot of questions are being raised tonight about a high-speed police chase in St. Clair County that has left one man dead, two others injured. The chase began when a car police were trying to stop in a traffic violation bolted. Minutes later, that car crashed head-on into a vehicle driven by 37-year-old Roger Allen Jones of Port Huron. He was killed instantly. His wife, Jean Marie, suffered severe head injuries. She's now hospitalized in critical condition. The driver of the fleeing car also hospitalized. He's in satisfactory condition. Port Huron police regulations call for officers to limit such chases to reasonable speeds. At this point, they say they have no indication the officers involved violated any guidelines, but an investigation is underway. What started out as a fun trip for a group of Central Michigan University students turned into a bad dream this weekend. 37 of the students were injured when the bus they were taking to Texas overturned in Indiana. Fortunately, all but one were released from hospital treatment. One young woman was kept for observation. Police say the bus driver apparently overcorrected when the bus went off one side of the interstate, sending it back across the highway where it overturned. In world news tonight, mutiny in the Philippines. A rebel governor has seized a hotel and is holding a government secretary and three top military officials hostage at this hour. An unspecified number of reporters and other government employees are also being held. Aguinaldo was suspended in early January. He apparently became violent when he discovered the government was preparing to attack his stronghold in a nearby town. 16 American soldiers have been injured by a bomb that appears to be the first attack on U.S. servicemen since the invasion of Panama in December. A grenade was thrown through the window of a crowded discotheque in Panama City last night. A total of 27 people injured in that incident. Questions are still being raised as to whether it was a political attack. No group has claimed responsibility. Of the 16 servicemen injured, one is hospitalized in serious condition. Trade relations between the U.S. and Japan have seen better days, but those days could be coming back if plans made today between President Bush and Japanese Prime Minister Toshiki Kaifu become reality. The leaders wrapped up 2 days of talks in Palm Springs, California. The U.S. is asking Japan to loosen import restrictions to help reduce Japan's nearly $50 billion trade advantage. Mr. Bush says the U.S. should take action in solving this problem.
But let's face it, these talks are a two-way street. We Americans must increase our savings, reduce our budget deficit, provide more incentive for our investors.
The President and I agreed to continuously enhance our relations with the understanding that the sound development of economic relations between our two countries is indispensable to the development of not only our economies, but that of the world economy.
While the tone of the talks was upbeat, no major agreements were made. In just a little under a half hour, the Easter Seal Telethon kicks off here at Channel 4 and nationally. Our hosts here, Mort Crim and Gary Danielson, are getting ready to spend a lot of hours on the air, trying to both educate people about disabilities and, of course, raise money to help those who use the Easter Seal services. Mort joins us live now to tell us just a bit more about the telethon and its goals this year. Mort?
And it'll be a late night for you too, Jennifer. We're looking for you and Paul Long, the rest of your crew, to come down the hall after the news and join us. There'll be an all-star cast of people, celebrities, sports figures from all around the metro area joining us here for this all-night telethon, which does begin at 11:30. Pat Boone, Mary Fran, Rob Weller heading an all-star cast in Hollywood. There'll be great entertainment, a terrific show for you, running from 11:30 tonight until 7 o'clock tomorrow night. The purpose, of course, is to raise money for Easter Seals, the organization here in the three-county area and indeed around the country that provides services, therapies, information to help the disabled, both children and adults. A terrifically good cause, something Gary Danielson and I have been doing and proud to be doing. This will be our 11th year, our 11th straight telethon. So we invite you to join us, watch the show, have a good time, have your wallets and your checkbooks and your pledges ready, and we'll be giving you phone numbers throughout the night. Jennifer, we'll see you in a few minutes.